All right, guys, welcome back. This is the TurboGrafx 16 CD-ROM system, and the game I'm about to play is one of the first CD-ROM games that came out in general, in gaming history. This is one of the first time music was actually music and not chiptune, and the first time voiceovers started to become a major thing. Cinematics started to become implemented. They're very practical cinematics, but cinematic nonetheless. This was when it first started. And so you guys are, if you'd like to stick around and watch this game, this is one of the first. This is how it started to grow. Games started to grow from a gaming experience, like a 16-bit, just a little thing, and they started to become movies. This is one of the first. So stick around. I'm going to jump right in here, and I hope you enjoy.
We, the Special Mission Unit, were sent here to rescue hostages upon a request from the Lloyd government. There was, however, no sight of a camp at the designated location. We had been tricked by the Lloyd regime. What met our eyes instead was... How could Lloyd's government betray us?
Colonel Kadat of the Republic of Libid, Mr. Lee of the Hong Kong Mafia, Chairman Steve of the Dual Foundation, Dr. Garcia, a brilliant physicist. With these four as its core figures, Force Project, an international armband, began its evil activities. Its aim was to rule the world by organizing massacres, blackmailing, terrorism, and smuggling of weapons.
Yes, Mr. President. We're certain that Lloyd betrayed us. It seems that the Force Project is behind them. Their ability should not be underestimated. Yes, I have someone in mind. Let me handle this.
Is it over?
He's entrusted me with the task.
So you'll ask him then?
The only person who could possibly fight the Force Project is this man. Guy Kazama is the only one.
All right, so you guys heard that the voice acting in this game is not so great, but it's done in a way that it's bad but good. So it's very odd, to say the least. So we're gonna jump in right into the first mission here.
I thought I'd find you here.
I thought we'd always do things together, even when we die.
We've received a report that Lloyd and the Force Project jointly developed a stealth aircraft.
You're not expecting me to steal it?
That's what I want. Spartan has already infiltrated into Lloyd's frontline base, Blue Rhinos. He'll be your assistant on this mission.
Well, I owe Lloyd and the Force Project one, and I always make it a rule to get square with these guys.
Guys, his name is Guy Kazama. What an awesome main character. When I was a kid, I think I played this game when I was about 12 years old. I think I was 11 or 12. No, I think I was young. I think I was 9 or 10. But, you know, this character, I thought he was kind of cool. We're gonna jump right in. See, now as you can see, it is a very old style bullet shooter. And for back in the day, I mean, look at these guys. They got blood splurting out. Back then, you didn't see that too much. So seeing them just like gushing blood all out of their chest like that, that was kind of graphic. Because if you guys, some of you remember back then, like, I don't even think Mortal Kombat had came out yet. So seeing something like this was kind of like, wow. It's like, This game is originally a Japanese game, so, you know, they didn't care about that too much. You can tell the dub in this is... it was very much dubbed. So I am going to try to do this playthrough all in one sitting, so this should be one video from start to finish. We're just going to kind of power right through this game. I haven't played it in several years, though I do... it is all coming back to me. I think the last time I played this game, I was maybe 12 or 13, so... but yeah, this was one of my favorites. Like, borrowing my brother's TurboGrafx system and playing these games was like a treasure for me, personally, because me and my brother, we were just kind of stuck with a, I think the Sega Genesis was out by this point. Possibly, I don't even think we had that. I think all we had was a Nintendo, but we might have had a Sega, but... you know, our games didn't have voiceovers, and it didn't have cool music like this. So, we're just like, this was like the future of gaming.
Guy Kazama, if you don't want the hostage killed, you should keep quiet.
Guy, the stealth bomber is in the back of this factory.
Okay, Spartan, hang in there just a while longer.
So hilarious. Me and my brother used to make fun of that all the time, that...
Guy! He's in the back room, Guy! Save me! Oh my!
That guy was so trying. It was obviously the same guy that was playing the villain trying to voice over the hostage. So it sounded really bad. These bosses can be a little annoying. Oop, I'm getting hit. I shouldn't be getting hit. There we go. You have successfully rescued your colleague and obtained the necessary information. Proceed with him to the hangar of the stealth aircraft. So the stealth aircraft, you have to undo these bombs. I think there's several bombs in here. Got all these enemies up here. This place, ooh, no. That was bad. This game can get pretty wild. This is one of those shooters. Hold on, let me get through these guys. They're gonna be annoying. This is one of those shooters that when you get really good with your weapons, you get weapon upgrades as you go. This is one of those shooters where you can get your stuff upgraded really good. But then if you get to a later level with all your upgrades and you die, you lose the upgrades. So that's really frustrating because now you're stuck with your crappy little gun trying to fight harder enemies. There's several games that used to do that in the past, you guys, that really irritated me. And it's just, I couldn't do it. Like, those games made me so mad. Those are the games you wanted to throw your controller through the wall. I'm sure a lot of you can empathize with that. So many games were unfair back then. They were cool, some of them were fun, but man, the fucking difficulty level, crazy. They was not balanced at all. This game I've beaten several times, I'm pretty sure, because I used to play this game so much. Because when you're a kid, I guess, I don't know why you want to play games like 20 times, but I did. And so I'm pretty confident I can do it again, I hope so. Hope I haven't lost my touch. I am 33 years old. I'm an old fart now, so it's like, I don't know if I still have my touch or not. I guess we're about to find out. I keep getting hit, and it's like, I shouldn't be. I like to preserve my life as much as possible. This game is only has two buttons. I think in this, you only ever use one button, and that's to shoot and then move, and that's it. Very simple games back then, you guys. Very simple. So I just have to find all these bombs before they blow up. Oh yeah, and there's that. There's like special items you can use and pick up. You only use those in emergencies though. And there's several different kinds you can get. Alright, where is this last bomb at? I think it's only one more left. There's one. There was a life, too. I hope it don't disappear. Nope, there is some more left. There's one. And the enemies just keep spawning, you guys. It does get annoying after a while. Come on, man, where's that last bomb? This place is only so big. There it is. Alright, let's get the heck out of Dodge. Oh! And then you just get up and do like that, and that's how you get rid of some of these guys. Here comes the next boss, I think, you guys. Yep. Another weird voice act.
Uh-oh. I see there's a welcoming committee out for me.
And that was it for that voiceover. But yeah, guys, if you lose, you see how I had an Uzi and I could switch to the Uzi? If I lost and died, that Uzi goes bye-bye. All my weapons go bye-bye. And it's really annoying. You guys have no idea. If you get to the last level and you die, because there's so many enemies and it's ridiculous, you need all that firepower. Alright, so board the stealth aircraft. Here we go. This is the end of the first level. This is the last level of the first stage. Oh yeah, I remember these guys. Yay, some life! Can't believe it, you guys. I'm doing so terrible here. Oh, I almost died again. Craziness. Yay.
Who are you?
We are from the Force Project. You'll have to come with me.
He's so nice, ain't he?
Did you hear about the jetliner that crashed in the Republic of Flett on the eastern side a week ago?
It seems President Allman has been taken prisoner.
It looks like President Allman is imprisoned in a camp on top of Mount Alt, about 50 kilometers northwest of the crash site. That's why I want you to.
You don't have to say any more than that.
He's like, I got this. Camp on top of the mountain and rescue the president. So you're going after the president, this one. Same kind of enemies, they just got snow coats on. Uh-oh. And they like to gang up on you, man. They're rare. The enemies in this game are very annoying. Okay, for enemies like that are up on top of the hill, you gotta throw a grenade up there to get them. Otherwise, you can't. Ooh, can't hit them. Get off of me! You just gotta press forward in this game and just hope they stop coming after you. I want some snow. I live in Florida, you guys, so it's like, it's always hot and stuff here, it's ridiculous. Oh, it's starting to get cold now, though, thankfully. I usually can get through this without using those special weapons until the end. You do need them at the end. Ow, get off of me, jeez. Thankfully this is right here. Alright, I think the first boss is coming up here.
Fool, Allman's already been taken away.
Well, then all I need to do is let you tell me where he is.
That voice, he just slipped into like... He just slipped into like Arnold Schwarzenegger for a second there, like he was trying to do an impression. That's hilarious. Okay, so yeah, these guys can get pretty annoying here. I usually like coming in at an angle and hitting them. Oh, come on. I gotcha. Oh yeah, the last one's easy. If I can get up here, I can just do that number on him. There you go. I'm like, screw it. Found out where the president is. Moving up. Oh, here come these annoying enemies again. See, after every boss you kill, they give you a little bit of life back. Not all of it. I think they give you like 3 squares back. Or 3 circles. Ah, come on. We gotta get the president, man. Oh, this is so annoying. I hate these. Hate these enemies. I think there's hostages I gotta rescue in this one. Yeah, it's timed again, too. Some of these levels are really annoying. Yeah, there's the hostages. It sucks because the flame doesn't even kill them right away. It takes like a half a second. Look at that. It's craziness. Ow, he still got me. Ah, man, you guys are annoying. There we go. Huh. The secret items. Lots of secret items. There we go. Ah, bullets. Stray bullets. Ooh, look at this. Like, item treasures down here. I like this. Oh, that's it. Probably gonna be an enemy waiting for me as soon as I get back out. Alright, so back up. I have like no life left. Come on. I need a health kit, please, somebody. Look at him walking up inside the Jeep. He's up here, isn't he? I don't think I've been up here. No, I haven't. Here he is. About time. Alright, you guys, that last hostage was so annoying to find, but I found him. And now I'm about to get the hell out of here. I love my new awesome gun. Hello.
President Allman, it's nice to see you're safe.
Thank you. I'm glad to see you made it safely. Now it's time for you to die.
Splendid voice acting. He looks like something from Minecraft. This is how you get... He's really easy. All you gotta do is get up on him and just start shooting like crazy. Killed the president. According to the rescued hostage, the real president seems to be leaving from the port for the enemy headquarters. Hurry. Alright, we're hurrying. Oh yeah, the music here is really good. Ow. Now I can just mow through these enemies. Yeah, once you upgrade your guns, mowing through the enemies becomes really easy, but the difficulty does amp up in later levels, so it accommodates for it. Ah, the snowman's melting. Poor snowman. Just killing all these dudes. There we go. Up. Mowing through it all. Look at that, just run. Oh! Kill all y'all like that. I don't care. Ouch. Mowing right through everybody, baby. Look at all that blood. Thank you. think we're coming up on the boss, you guys. Yep.
The president is an important guest for us too, you know. I can't let him go.
He's so nice.
That makes me want to get him back even more.
Huh. Hey. I love Guy Kazama. He's so cheesy. They're like really bad one-liners. I love it. This game is just full of bad, really bad one-liners. You just gotta stay away from those missiles. There we go. Not too bad. The president has been rescued safely.
This is very sudden, Leonard.
Well, take a look at this.
This is...
Colonel Kadat of Libid. You know him?
Well, he's a famous man, controlling all the terrorists around the world. I'd even want to get an autograph from him.
I want you to assassinate him.
That wild horse, Robert, from the Green Beret's face?
He's been captured and is in the Arcado camp. Colonel Kadat is in hiding. I hear that the only ones who know of his whereabouts are his guards, Red, Blue, and Black.
So, I'll have the pleasure of becoming friends with them.
Camp and get Mr. Man out. Ooh, look at all that. Everybody is dead. Yeah, this game has one of the best music tracks. I love it. I think we're towards the middle of the game now. Not too long of a game. Oh yeah, you can rescue those guys. Thankfully you don't, I don't think you have to rescue these guys like in the other ones. You might, but they're not as hard as the other two levels. I never really remember ever having trouble with this level. Yeah, all these enemies, man, they just keep coming. If I had a regular gun here, it would be terrible because you have to shoot them more than once too. Sucks. I could go for a level up right about now. Alright. See, they just keep throwing them at you, man. Can you imagine if you had a newer game and they just kept throwing enemies, just spawning enemies like crazy? Through the whole game. Not through part of the game. Through the whole game. Because these enemies just keep spawning and spawning and spawning. It is annoying. There's some that are deliberately placed there, but, like, all these guys are a spawn. Oh my goodness, I'm about to die again. Get these guys off of me. Too many. Too many. Too many. Time's running out. Oh, gotta make it. I gotta make it. I think we made it. Okay.
I'll burn you to death with these flames. How do you want it done? Rare or medium?
Sorry, I don't like roast pork.
Man, what you talking about? I love roast pork. Look how fat this guy is. Oh my god, he's so annoying too. Oh man, I shot the hostage. Okay, he's gone. That was annoying. Robert, you have found out where Colonel Kadat's three aides are and what they're like. Alright, so we'll go up here first. Red, we'll kill Red first. If you guys noticed, if you look closely, you'll remember a game called Metal Tank. This game's made by the same people.
Clear the way! Guy Kazama, you better watch what you say to me. I'm really quick on the trigger.
I think it was Metal Tank. It was either that or another game. It was made by the same people, though. Oh my gosh, this dude. Okay. I'm just gonna get up here and... There we go. Find out where Colonel is, and looks like his underground fortress. Alright, ready to go defeat Black. I need an upgrade, man. It's time to upgrade my life. I really do need to upgrade my real life. Moving right along, just zippity-doo-dah and right through these guys. Look at all the chickens, they give me stuff. These are the best chickens ever. Kill a chicken, they drop life and grenades and all kinds of cool things. I'm just like running through everybody now. It's like I don't care anymore. You guys, I probably am going to skip through some of these levels because as you can see, it's a lot of the same. Like the enemies are the same. And I know you guys can get bored with all this stuff. Nowadays, it's easy to get bored with stuff like this. So for some of these levels, I'm just going to kind of pop through them real quick. Because there's not much to them. It's mostly the cinematics that you want to see. So, you know, I'll come to a level, if it has new music, I'll let you listen to it once through. And then I'll pop it to the next, usually to the end if I'm taking too long. Oh, there we go.
Hey, guy! Let my baby Betty throw you a kiss!
You're some weirdo naming your helicopter.
Hey, guy! I used to think that was cool. Now it's corny. His helicopter's all... I actually forgot how to get rid of this guy. I think he comes out of the helicopter eventually. Yeah, he comes down and it drops him off. There it goes. I always wonder what he's holding. It looks like a giant drill. Like a jackhammer he's holding. It's funny. Alright, you guys, this next one has my favorite boss. Just because of what he says. He like sings it and you'll see at the end. It's so funny. It's not really funny now, but back then I was like, okay. That was kind of corny, but kind of cool at the same time. Yeah, you'll hear it in a second. Oh my god, these guys with missiles. Jeez. Just killing me. Give me some. Aw, man. Every time. They get me right on. Annoying. Ah, come on, man. You guys are so annoying. Give me my little bit of life back. Jeez. This river's going to a red with your blood. I have never forgotten that line. You know what? I just walked all the way back to the beginning, I think. The grenade launcher is really not all that great compared to the other gun. Like, this gun, I think, is better.
This river's gonna turn red with your blood.
How interesting, but it's going to be your blood, not mine.
Best line in the whole game, you guys. It's so bad. He's pretty easy. You just get up on him and, like, pop some bullets on him. Especially when he comes up right beside you. I only hit him once that time. That's terrible. He's a little annoying. Just because it takes so long to kill him and he only pops up for like a half a second. There we go. Just have to shove it in his face. Alright. Going to that secret underground lair they were talking about. Look at all these enemies. They're like friggin' animals in a cage. And you gotta bust these guns up so you can get in. I could have just ran over them, but some stuff you just can't avoid. You just let it hit you. And you just run through it. Hey, I'm here already? Oh, wow.
Gai Kazama, how dare you kill these precious men whom I've trained?
Well, Colonel, you haven't done a very good job of training them.
You can tell that there's like one voice actor voicing like all the characters. It's ridiculous. There's like one or two voice actors. Like the last guy with the in the water, that was obviously the one black dude that they found to do that one line. And he sang it, which was perfect. Here comes a terrible Asian accent, you guys.
I have received information about a CIA dog, Gai Kazama, who assassinated a member of the Force Project, Colonel Kadai.
He intends to enter the martial arts tournament you host every year to kill you, Mr. Lee.
Really? Well, that's interesting.
So we plan to present you with three of the toughest fighters.
By the way, Dr. Garcia, how is the development of your ultimate weapon, Indra, coming along?
Yeah, it should be completed within a month.
Dr. Garcia is like the coolest character in this game, and he's so like ridiculous. Alright, so we're gonna go into communications first. I think this is that girl. The girl with the claws. I'm just running through. Ow. Oh, here she is. Oh no, this is the guy. He had to have his cool intro theme. Ah! This is my cheating way, you guys. Just stand right beside him and blow him to bits. To the mysterious building. As if it matters. I think this one has the girl. Yeah, because they're all, notice how no blood comes out of the girls. They just kind of twirl and then cry. Huh. Can't be killing the girls in Japan. Oh my goodness. Oh, this is annoying. Yay, give me that. I need it. Oh, and I'm gonna lose it. Right after I just got it. Ah. Here she is.
You're not going any further without defeating me.
Sorry, but ladies first doesn't apply on a battlefield.
Alright, guy. Stop overacting, guy. Look at her. She is the weakest boss. Look at this. Terrible. She shoots one bullet. Like, how is she supposed to be tricky at all? I would think that she would have been, like, shooting a spray of, like, my gun, at least. But no, they give her one bullet. How sad is that? Come on. You guys could have made her awesome, at least. They made her pose awesome enough. One bullet. Seriously? I feel sorry for her. Alright. Last place to the cave. Not the last level, but we're getting there. We're close to the last level. Oh, these enemies are annoying, you guys. They take so many shots. It's so annoying. And then there's these ones that are on fire that just stand there. Oh, yes. I need that.
Hey, you fatso, you're blocking the traffic.
Hee-hee, guy, I'm gonna destroy you.
Oh, man. Hee-hee, guy, I'm gonna destroy you. That was also my favorite line. Hey, fatso, move out the way. I'm in a kind of a hurry. I'm gonna destroy you. Do these lines, and I remember them too, like. Okay. It's time to go get Mr. Lee. There's our encouraging music, guys. Our, what do you call it? Our patriotic music, because we're at the last level of this stage, and we're gonna go get Mr. Lee. Take him down. Are you guys excited? I bet you are. I bet you're like, what in the hell is wrong with this guy? Why is he playing old games? I'm just watching it because I want to see how much of a bad player he is and how dumb his commentary is. Jeez. Why does he have to play old games? I just can't handle it, man. I'm gonna go crazy. I never want to watch him play any games ever again. It's ridiculous. Ridiculous. People used to play this trash? What in the hell was wrong with people, man? Hey, I don't care what you guys are saying. We're about to go kill Mr. Lee. And you gotta be happy for the fact that we're about to destroy Mr. Lee. I mean, what the hell, man? It's Mr. Lee and all his chicks. Look, they're robot chicks. They're all exploding and stuff. And he's got his little Shaolin monks after me. Guys, we're here. We're at Mr. Lee. We're about to take him out.
I guess those three were no match for you. Let me be your opponent now.
It's terrible.
Mr. Lee, this tower is beginning to look like your tombstone.
Oh, man. Such a disgraceful accent for the Asian guy. Are you serious? Come on, Mr. Lee, I gotcha. Mr. Lee, would you die already? Jeez, you almost got me. Mission accomplished. Mr. Lee is no match for me. Isn't this nice? We're on a cruise, a luxury cruise. It's in Japanese.
He's just a double.
You mean he's an imposter?
Members of the Force Project would not appear that easily before the public.
Guy, I checked around the ship. They're loading an enormous amount of state-of-the-art weapons on here, like you said.
I've planted explosives on this ship. We'll use that to look for the real Steve.
This ship, as opposed to what other ship? You hear
how- To the prosperity and glory of the Dual Foundation. Cheers!
As opposed to what- He enunciated this, like he was talking about, like there's other ships. Huh. You guys need to learn how to voice act, man. His Mission Impossible pose. Oh yeah, you gotta go through the boat. Look at his nice wear. And then they're so lazy about the voice acting that they didn't even voice over the guy speaking in the background, which was the president. Oh man, already getting smoked. Hey look, you can blow up the food. All right guys. That you can tell that this is a retro game, because in what game can you blow up the food and get an item out of it? It's so terrible. guys see how I never use these special items? I just think half of them are really useless. There's only one item that's useful, and I'll show you guys what that one is. This thing. And I don't want to use it yet because I only have two and I'm going to need them later. I'll show you when I get there.
I guess you're what they call an uninvited guest.
Oh, so funny.
So what are you going to do with me?
I'll throw you into the sea after I get you.
He did his Arnold impression again. This guy cannot make up his mind on his voice acting decisions. Guys, do yourself a favor when you go to voice act. Don't do it like that. These guys are horrible. But it's funny. When you're young and you're playing these games, it's not even funny. You just don't know what to make of it because you're young and you accept that that's the way that they're supposed to sound, you know? But anybody, like, in a studio director that's old enough would be like, that's horrible. Like, that's horrible to me. But as a kid, adults don't know it, but I mean, as a kid, you just accept that that's their voice. You really don't care when you're a kid. Alright, so I died that last time, so here we are again with Steve.
You've shown me some fancy action here. The damages on this ship and the weapons aboard will come to $1 billion.
People will hate you, Steve, if you're too stingy.
Stingy. Did you guys hear that? He pronounced the word stingy wrong. He said stingy. That is hilarious. I never caught on that. I always wondered what he said as a kid. As a kid, I thought he said, people will hate you, Steve, if you're too Stevie. And I thought he was just being really cheesy. But he said how dumb do you have to be? How did this guy get hired as a voice actor if he can't even pronounce the word stingy correctly? Stingy. That's ridiculous. That is the funniest thing I have ever heard. I never caught on to that when I was a kid. Alright, so let's go get Dr. Garcia. Oh, we did it. It's the We Did It music. Yay! Time to celebrate. Look at the president. He's like he just got done fapping. They're all just like, okay.
I'm the only one remaining of the Force Project members. But I have completed the ultimate weapon, Indra. Once it's launched, it will put an end to all mankind.
That's what I'm talking about.
They shall be punished. but don't lose heart.
Okay.
I'll give you just one last chance.
All right. One last.
Unfortunately, it takes 24 hours to launch Indra.
Okay.
If you can destroy Indra within that time, you win.
Oh, I'm gonna win these.
But there's only one man who's allowed to play this game.
This game?
That's Guy Kazama. I'm looking forward to seeing you.
Ooh, I'm gonna go throw up in the toilet now.
As the President of the United States, I ask you, save all mankind.
Okay, I will.
I'll try. But I can't take the responsibility. This mission is just too great.
I know you can do it.
You can never trust Leonard.
I always wondered what the conflict between him and Leonard was, because it's very vague. Leonard's the one with the blue suit on. It almost seems like they had some... This is the last level, guys. It always seemed like they had some problems or something, but they don't cover that. So it's like... He has some weird issue with Leonard, and then he likes him again at the end, but I guess maybe he had contempt for him at some point. They don't cover that in the story. Maybe the Japanese did, but in the American dub, they make it very vague, and it's just very awkward and weird. I try to figure characters out, but with this bad of a dub, it's just half-assed. up. For this part, you just run straight up. Usually you can make it through without getting shot, but I didn't right there. So guys, this is the end. We've made it to the end of the game, and you just pretty much power mode through these guys, because it's pretty difficult trying to get through some of this. Well, maybe not now, because I've leveled up so much. Look at my life bar, man. It's ridiculous. I'm in Final Command. I don't think I can level up anymore. Maybe I can. I don't know. I mean, Final Command sounds pretty final to me, but we'll see, because it's about to hit it again. I'm about to level up again, man.
Guy, long time no see. Is it you, Dark? You're still alive? Dr. Garcia brought me back to life. You won't get me that easily this time, Guy Kazama. Uridica.
What is that supposed to mean? Dude, I just destroyed all those guns like crazy. That was funny. Alright, so you just gotta get up here and go to town on him. There you go. Aw, man, I gotta go 3 more levels, seriously? Well, that water is really annoying to look at on an HD screen. Wasn't like that on a standard definition screen. Wow, man. I'm gonna level up in here, probably. Oh, I'm a one-man army. This is kind of a...
There's someone in the water. Something just grazed past my knee.
Grazed past my knee. Of course, that's how you would say it, too. You wouldn't be scared or anything. Oh. Woo! Gotcha. It was a dragon. Craziness. That did not look like a dragon. I guess it was an Asian dragon. Oh, good. They gave me my life back. Jeez, I need that.
You're the infiltrator?
I am.
I haven't had a visitor in a long time.
Well, shit, you need to get out more.
I don't need your hospitality. Just let me pass. I'm in a kind of a hurry.
He's in a kind of a hurry again.
Here, take this.
Wow. Like he's gonna give me something. Got rid of you. One more. And you're dead too. The most annoying thing ever, you guys.
So we meet finally, Dr. Garcia.
Guy Kazama, you have foiled every one of my ambitions. You're going to have to pay for this.
Ah! I almost got hit by that. Just stand here and break his mirror. He ran away. I like how he just got in the shuttle while he was in his chair. My guy's all like, I like how they just have 2 shuttles just sitting right beside each other, ready to go. Now we are in Indra. Look at our shuttles. Alright. Pushing on to the end of the story. Oh, these ones are a lot easier to blow up compared to the last ones. Everything just blows right up. Look at this. No problem. Oh, good. I need that. Oh, here we are.
Why would a hireling soldier like you run such a risk to torment me like this? Why?
Garcia, nobody can hire my feelings.
I was like, wow. When I got to this point as a kid, you don't think about it, but it crosses your mind as a child. You're like, wow, the villain had a little bit of a compassion in his voice. Or like, he's so passionate about his what he wants to do. Even though they're bad voice actors, he showed a little bit of a decision there on that line. He didn't deliver it angry like most of the other lines, even though it was still kind of bad. So now you see that Dr. Garcia is in fact himself a robot, which I thought was kind of cool.
I've lost. But Indira's already been started. It'll put an end to humanity.
Isn't there a way to stop Indra?
Not unless you destroy Indra. But if you do, if you do, you will also die.
Poor Garcia. He died. All his green battery acid just fell out. Look, there he is. Finish him off. Alright, so now we gotta go kill Indra, and it's up here. Yeah, we're gonna make it, baby. We're gonna make this. Oh, I need that. Thank you. Now for this thing, this is when you use it. It's just pretty much an annoying boss at this point. Oh, there it goes. Oh, it's still going. Indra does not want to die.
C019045. This is Guy calling Secretary Leonard. C019045. This is Guy calling Secretary Leonard.
Guy, it's you, Guy!
This is Leonard. You're alive. I knew you could do it.
I said I couldn't trust anything you said, but it seems, for once, you were right.
Don't worry about that. Where are you?
I wonder. The signal's already been sent. I'm tired of sunbathing. Come and pick me up right away.
That was Last Alert, ladies and gentlemen. Very dated, but the music's cool. That's what I really loved about this game, was the music. Alright guys, I want to thank you for joining in on this playthrough of Last Alert. And we'll see you back for the next video. No, I'm not done with Fallout. For those of you that are following Fallout during this point in time of watching this video, we'll continue that story as well. And take care. Have a good morning, good evening, good brunch, or good night. Bye-bye.